Hi, Dr. Lisa Thompson of DrLisaMThompson.com, and I'm coming to you from my home office outside Eden Prairie, Minnesota. On today's episode of The Doctor's In, I'm going to share with you seven strategic locations to put call to actions in your blog so that you can get the most leads and sales for your business. So stay tuned. Over the last 7 months, I have been studying the top bloggers, the 6 and 7 figure earners, and what they do to optimize their leads and sales on the blog. And what they do is they have strategic placements of their call to action spread throughout their website and throughout their blog posts that gets them leads consistently. And it's not just placing opt-in forms or banner ads on the right-hand column that you see here on your screen. Because what's happening is that many people are turning a blind eye to anything on that right-hand column. So we have to maximize getting people to see what we want them to see by placing call to actions in very strategic locations. So let's start with the home page. On your screen right now, here is my homepage. If you don't have a homepage, you must have one. And here's why. We've often said that the blog is your headquarters. Your homepage is the reception area where people know who you are and what you're about. And what you need to have at the very top of your homepage is a 30-second welcome video that is going to give them a direct call to action to get your free gift, which is whatever your branded giveaway is. Now, if you go to my website at DrLisaMThompson.com, you can listen to my welcome video. Now, what you can do is you can either have an opt-in form up here or you can use a banner ad. You can test and see what works well. And right now, this is very effective for me. So if people click here, they are going to get access to my free video training, my social media marketing playbook. Where I also have another strategic call to action is at the bottom. Typically, when people are listening to your welcome video, they're going to be scrolling down to see what else you have on your page. So they may not click here right away. Remember, people have the attention span of a gnat these days. So I'm going to come down and remind them again, but I'm going to reiterate my branded giveaway in a different way, where I'm going to say, receive Dr. Lisa's recent blog post and claim your free video training on how to attract 8 to 10 leads a day using social media. So if they put their name and address in, that's still going to get them on my list and they're going to get the free training. Now at the bottom, you see down here, there is a plugin you can get. It's a premium plugin. It's called Quickie Bar Pro, and you can add a little bar, an opt-in bar, that can be either at the bottom or at the top. Now with my particular WordPress theme, it does not work at the top, so I keep mine at the bottom. As you can see here, this is another place where they can get information about what I do. Now, on the particular blog post itself, there's a couple of ways we can monetize and get them to opt in. Below my featured image here, I have what is called the What Would Seth Godin Do plugin. This is a free plugin, and you can put out messages to first-time visitors and repeat visitors. And what this is here, now the key in any type of opt-ins that are on your homepage and on the What Would Seth Godin Do plugin must be consistent. So your What Would Seth Godin Do message should reiterate the free training that you have on your homepage, because I want them to go back and get that giveaway. So I'm going to say, welcome back. As a token of my appreciation, here's a free copy of my video training where it spells out the strategies and systems. Okay, so it's my social media marketing playbook, and they can access it here. Now, what I also do within the blog post itself, okay, I make sure that any clickable link is blue and underlined. That is huge, and I'm going to tell you why. My husband, he teaches technology in a parochial school from grades K through 8. He teaches his students that at any time they see a blue text that's underlined, That's a clickable link for you to click on. That's the way we've been trained. And you want to make sure that you're seeing your blog posts from your prospect sites, because I can't tell you how many times people are missing out on leads because they don't have their clickable links blue and underlined. You're missing out on so much, because people know that if their eyes are attracted to a blue underlined text, that's a clickable link. I better check that out. So you really make sure you want to take advantage of that. So what I like to do, and I'm getting very effective results with it, is I'll state like what I want them to do. You know, I have a purpose for my post where I want them to go to a specific training or a specific sales page. I'll set the table up here, okay? So I'll have something up here at the top, and then I'm gonna reiterate the offer again down on a PS line. That's another excellent strategic call to action. Because what you want to do is you want to give your blog posts enough content that satisfies, takes the edge off of solving the problem, but they want more. And so having that PS can direct them to where they can receive more training or invest in a course that is related to this topic. Now, another way you can get strategic call to actions is in the image itself. What I like to do with my images, I will put a clickable link, okay, to an opt-in based on the topic of this blog post. So as this blog post is about Facebook engagement, I belong to a mastermind with one of my good friends and marketers, Lisa Torres. She has a social media marketing mastermind. So if people clicked on this link here of me and Lisa, it's going to take her to an opt-in form where if people wanted to become a part of that mastermind group, they can do so. Now, the last thing I want to share with you where you can get these leads is having what's called a pop-up. Now, a lot of people do not like having pop-up ads, and it's very important to have only one. If you have too many that come up, it is going to, you know, number one, tick them off. No one likes to be shutting down pop-ups. So you want, if you have pop-ups about wanting to connect with you, get rid of those if you're going to be using a pop-up here for an opt-in form. And so what I do with this particular opt-in form is this is reiterating what I have offered on my homepage, okay, and on my What Would Seth Godin Do plugin. I want them to be opting into what my branded giveaway is. So what I like to do is that if people, you know, from my blog post, I'll say, thanks for reading this post. I want to send you a free gift. And then all they have to do is enter in their information and they will get my social media marketing playbook. The key when you're doing call to actions is consistency and congruency. Congruency is very important. So you don't want your pop-up ad here to be something totally different than what you have on your homepage and your What Would Seth Godin Do. Keep everything consistent and you're going to see different results for your business. You're going to see more leads and more sales coming to you. Did you find this video helpful? Leave a comment and share, and make sure you like my Facebook fan page so you never miss another episode the doctor is in. And get your free gift, my social media marketing playbook, which is a video training specifically designed to help you attract your perfect prospect to you in minutes a day using social media. Thank you so much for watching today's episode of The Doctor Is In, and I'll talk to you tomorrow.